Yes, I'm going to walk. Oh, that milky white way. Oh, child, some of these days. Well, I'm going to walk that milky white way. Oh, some of these days. Well, 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 I'm going to walk up and take up my stand. Gonna join that Christian band. I'm going to walk, whoa, that milky white way. Oh Lord, some of these days I'm gonna tell my, oh, my mother, howdy, 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 when I get home. Yes, I'm going to tell my mother howdy when I get home. Well, 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 I want to tell my mother hey when I shake mother hand that day. That's when I want, oh, that milky white way, some of these days. I want to meet God the Father and God the Son.
Holy and acceptable unto me. in his holy place. He that has clean hands and a pure heart, who has not lifted his hand, his soul into vanity, nor sworn deceitfully, he shall receive the blessing from the Lord and righteousness from the God of salvation. This is the generation of them that seek Him, and they that seek Thy face, O Jacob, Zion. Lift up your heads, all ye gates, and be lifted up, the everlasting doors, and the King of glory shall come in. Question: who is the King of glory? The Lord strong and mighty, the Lord mighty in battle. Lift up your heads, all ye gates. Even lift them up, you everlasting doors, and the King of glory shall come in. Question: who is this King of glory? The Lord of hosts is the King of glory. I have faith, unless I have seen and believed. When they said unto me, may Israel say, if it has not been the Lord who was on our side, with men broke waiting patiently. in our order service. Amen. We have, this year we have the program. And the family made the program. Hopefully that we can, you know, stay within those guidelines, what was rearranged, what was written. And as we call each and every one of just being mindful that we have a program to be able to kind of keep us going and moving forward. Amen?
Amen.
Amen. At this time, we're going to call Dr. Edward B. Jones for our prayer this morning.
Amen. Let us all bow our heads. Heavenly Father, we thank you in the name of Jesus.
Amen.
For your goodness and your grace. Oh God, as we have come to celebrate the homegoing of our loving auntie, sister, just for your many blessings that you have given us throughout the years.
Amen.
God, we pray that you just comfort our hearts and strengthen us in our soul. God, that as we hold on to the memories,
yes,
and we release her unto you, God.
Yes.
Oh God, that you will build us up in faith, and God, that you will keep us together so that, God, that your glory be revealed even in this moment.
Yes.
We thank you now in the name of Jesus.
Yes.
And oh God, we pray now for healing.
Yes.
Oh God, right now, from the depths of our soul, from the inside out. God, we thank you and we praise you now.
Yes.
We're going to give you the glory forever. We're going to give you the praise.
Yes.
Hallelujah, in the name of Jesus.
Yes.
That God, that you are glorified in every area, no matter what the circumstance.
Yes.
We thank you in Jesus' name. Let the believers say amen.
Amen.
Prayer does good as medicine. It helps us in a time to strengthen us when we're being torn down at. And it also builds us up. Amen?
Amen.
At this time, I'm going to call Old Testament Scripture, Pastor Lamar Thomas.
Good afternoon, everybody. I want to read six verses to you that you're hearing from the book of Isaiah 53. And this is what it says in verse 1. Who has believed our report? And to whom has the arm of the Lord been revealed? For he grew up before him as a tender plant and a root out of dry ground. He had no form of majesty that we should look upon him, no appearance that we should desire him. He was despised and rejected of men, a man of sorrow and acquainted with grief. And we hid, as it were, our faith from him. And he was despised, and we did not esteem him. Surely he has bore our grief and carried our sorrow. Yet we esteem him stricken, smitten of God, afflicted. But he was wounded for our transgression. He was bruised for our iniquity. The chastisement of our peace was upon him. And by his stripes we are healed. All of us, like sheep, have gone astray. Each of us have turned to his own way. But the Lord had laid on him the iniquity of us all. Amen.
Amen.
And Lord, have a blessing to the readers, the hearer, and doer of his word.
Amen. Amen. That's another reason. Sister Karen had many ways to reach out to other people along the way. but at the same time, by her departing from labor to reward, now we came out because she called God out of her to bring us to one common ground, neutral ground on today. And I tell you, I bless God to know that God is awesome to see things through from one end to the other end, and then yet at the end, he get all the glory. And like I was saying, you know, all death is not final. It's not final, just a beginning. Right. At this time, I'm going to call around for the New Testament scripture, Dr. Ulysses Morgan.
I have fought a good fight. I have kept the faith. I have finished my course. Now is laid upon me a crown of righteousness that the Lord, thy righteous judge, shall give in that day. Not only to me only, but to all those who love his appearance. Second letter I wrote to Pastor Timothy by Paul, 4th chapter, 7 and 8 verse. His word is blessed.
Amen. All right, sir.
Amen. Amen. I want to be able to stand on that holy ground to know that when the final analysis and everything is said and done, that he can say that you can say, I fought a good fight.
Yes, sir.
You didn't give in, you didn't give out. Then keeping the faith. In this day and time, you have to fight a good fight.
Yes, sir.
In order to have endurance. And I think along the way, others that we see have done those things, reminded us that we can do those things also. Amen?
Amen.
Praise be to God. Hallelujah. And at this time, we're going to begin to open up another part of the service of reflection. And that's a part that, you know, it says that family, friends will may desire, but also say kind of let it be limited to at least 2 minutes. Amen?
Amen.
As I said before, it's kind of hard at times to pour a gallon into a quart. And you know what I'm saying? It's kind of, it's hard to do. Amen? But it can be done if it's spilled. Amen? But it's time to open up for reflection. Amen? Okay, First Lady.
I want to say that Sister Carrie was part of Power Deliverance Church for years. She was an usher. She was faithful on her job. She had a favorite song, Sister. I can't remember what it was, but she would sing that every praise and worship service time. And we could look forward to hearing her sing that song post-service started. One thing about it, she wasn't ashamed of it. She didn't care. She kept talking about she singing over, she sung. And that was one thing about Sister Carrie. Sister Carrie is going to tell you what she thought. She'll shake her head and hold her head down, but she'll tell you what she thought. And I appreciated her during the time that she served under my leadership, and we just thank God that we had the opportunity to be a pastor to her. Now, Sister Carrie, every year she would call my number. I said, hi, Sister Carrie. She said, Pastor Morgan, how you doing? I'm just making my rounds. that she was calling every pastor. She would call every year.
Yeah.
About that time, now that was that to me, that was kind of unique.
Yes.
She would call everyone that she had the privilege of serving upon them and just say hello and pray for her and what have you. And that will stick with me if nothing else would. Because I've never seen that happen before. But she was a person, again, and this came to mind. And Sister Carrie didn't understand what you were teaching. She gonna keep talking to you until she gets it. And you can try to move on if you want to. She gonna raise her hand, you know, the old Pentecostal way. Say, well, I sometimes she won't ever look at, she'll look to the side and say, I just gotta get it. You had to sit there and explain to Sister Carrie exactly what you're talking about, which to me was great. Because there's no need of coming to church and then leave without an understanding of what has been taught. But she was sure to get an understanding. Okay, no matter where you went, what you said, if she didn't get it, she gonna tell you, I didn't get it. So she was a lovely person. And I thank God for her. Amen. And I just praise God for the time we had together. But I think, as the elder has said, this is just an absentee time. We will all see each other again as we pass this way.
Amen.
Sister Carrie, she's out of pain. And I just want to stand here and say that on her behalf. Because I know she's listening, and to let her know that I greatly appreciate her and her service. Amen.
Amen.
Amen. I'm the oldest, I even remember her childhood. And her childhood that she always, always wanted to know what her mother was. The family, yeah. It's what my daddy used to call empathy. And when I was growing up, I put myself in her place. And I looked at her. And if you got any spirit of God inside of you, you could discern a hurt that was on the inside of her. And she always wanted to know what a mom was like. So we talked about it.
Amen.
And she told me, she said, only thing I can get out of it is people describing to me who she was. But she wanted to know her mother. And I tell you one thing, the thing that I remember my mom making her for in her place, I remember her prom. She had on the most beautiful gown, white glove, beautiful blue dress, and everybody knows she always wanted the two bowls on her head, on the one in her hair. That was her motto. And her name was Carrie Belle. And she could ring that bell. She's a bell ringer. She's gonna be heard.
Wow.
But the thing about her, she spoke to me now in the final ministry that she was in, but she always talked about these two gentlemen, how they poured into her life. You know, whether it was one way or the other. And then she said she loved her pastor. But the thing is, God gave all of the increase. He did all of the glory. Whether it was good times, bad times, indifference, or whatever. But the thing is, Sister Carrie, she was a trailblazer. She dug a path. She was gifted.
Yes, you are.
Yes, she was. She was gifted to knit, sew, whatever, make things, arts and crafts. And not only that, she was a person that when she got to the end of the road, she understood everything. Yes. She was going to get her understanding. And as we sat in that bed and we held hands, and we made promises to each other, and we loved on each other, and it was hard to let go that day, but I had to go. She told me that, Chip, you know what? God is going to restore. That was my baby. And she always believed in restoration of anything. And now as I look at her today, and hopefully after she saw Jesus, the most important thing was that she saw her mother. That was very important to her. My mother raised him up. And it was problems, but then again, who wouldn't want to see that mother? You know, you have to go through trials and tribulations, but God did restore her. And I knew that after she saw Jesus,
yes,
first face, she saw him.
Amen.
Today, but her heart and her prayers are with us. She shared that she came to Cordele in the late 70s And the Jones family is a part of the first people with whom she connected or met. She talked about Carrie and some of her vernaculars. She talked about her ushering and singing in the choir. And I was trying to remember one of my visits of how I was her singing, but I can't remember her singing probably. but Aunt Carrie was a giver. I can remember the summers coming to Cordele, and she was always the diva. We talked about her hair, and some of the cousins were talking about wearing a flower. And I'm the oldest, so I'm not wearing a flower. That was her trademark. You know? She loved to wear a flower, and we weren't trying to take her place with that. Sister Morgan also shared that Aunt Carrie served at the Senior Citizens Center. Everybody knows that she was quite crafty. She was a skilled seamstress. At times thought she was a skilled baker. So that's an inside joke in your family. So we eventually convinced her to leave the baking dough. But she loved hard, if you will. And she especially loved children.
Yeah.
They talked about her driving the bus.
Yeah.
I don't know if I would have wanted to ride the bus, but she drove the bus. Sister Morgan talked about how you would see the bus coming around the corner, and all you can see is that million-dollar smile.
Yeah.
But that was Aunt Carrie. She spoke of their frequent phone calls and how she would call to check on her, and they had a set time on Sunday evenings. And she looked forward to that time. She talked also about the fact that she had a conversation several years back with Aunt Carrie, and Aunt Carrie told her, when I die, I want you to have a t-shirt that says, yes, it's me. And you knew Aunt Carrie. When she arrived, she was on the scene, and everybody knew that she was present. And if you act like you didn't want to give her attention, she's going to let you know about that too. And then she spoke of, and I thought this was so profound, again, going back to they would call and they would check on each other. And on Wednesday, March 20th, she had called, Aunt Carrie didn't answer. And so she thought, well, we'll speak again like we normally do on Sunday evening. But on last Sunday evening, she didn't get to have that conversation. And as Sister Morgan put it, Sister Carrie answered the ultimate call. And that was her call from the Master.
Yes.
And so we are indeed grateful to Sister Morgan for all of the kind words that she had to share. And she could only imagine Aunt Carrie as she entered heaven saying, it's me.
It's me.
It's me.
Amen. Auntie was like a second mother to me. My mom used to always tell me when I was a baby, she couldn't keep me quiet, I'm crying. Auntie would come get me, take me to her room, and I'd stay with her. As I got older, she continued to look out for me. She did, you know, different works in the community. One thing in particular that I remember was she would get the elderly, she'd put them on the bed, and she'd take them to, like, events, you know, parades and stuff like that. So she'd come pick me up and tell me that she wanted me to help her for the weekend. I stayed the night with my auntie several weekends. And we'd get up in the morning, we'd go round everybody up, we'd take them to the parade or whatever, then take them back. I applaud staying with her on the weekends when she did come pick me up. She had several other little side hustles and jobs that she did. She would bring me with her so I could make a little extra money. And with that extra money between that and more, I ain't saying y'all,
I played to buy my first basketball hoop. I remember wearing a pair of Nikes in my school clothes when I was in seventh grade. And she continued to look out for me when I got to college. It got to the point where I wanted to move out of the dorm and into my own apartment, but I didn't have a vehicle at the time. And that old blue Impala that she used to drive around Cordele, she gave it to me. And my Uncle Willie and my dad, they fixed it up and got it back on the road. That's how I was able to commute from Warner Rogers to Fort Bend. Yeah. She always looked out for me. Even when I moved away, when I got married, had kids, moved away, she would call me, talk to myself, my wife, my kids. A lot of times on Saturdays or Sundays, it didn't matter. I'm looking at these pictures, and obviously she was very photogenic. Yeah. I don't know if my favorite color was red, but my favorite color was always red. And I, before I moved away, she gave me this one picture. She was in the office in her chair at her desk, and she had on a red dress and a sit-up sock. And I still got that picture to this day. So I'm gonna miss some conversations with her, but I'll never forget that even throughout every stage of my life, you know, she had looked out for me, she always done. If she couldn't do it, she was gonna call and talk to me, or my kids as well, you know. So I'm gonna miss talking to her, but you know, she was just like my second mother.
You know, I tell you, it was amazing. I think one of the visiting nurses, when I would always be over there, you know, a lot in the house there, done a lot of her chores and everything. But this particular day, she said, you know what? She said, Dean take care of Johnny, and Johnny take care of me. Do the thing that I need done. And I said, okay, Mrs. Karen. My God, I tell you. Amen. And there's another reflection before we go to the musical. There's another reflection before we go to the musical.
We know this is not our home, we just passed through.
Yes,
so, them life is a part of his family. Now, y'all said Carrie Belle, but I'm in there front. No, not long. Did I talk? I said, what you doing? Nothing. I said, you better not be doing that. I'm going to get a picture on you. You know, I just had the time, and I'm glad that our God gave me the time and God allowed us to come together. And if we want to see Sister Carrie again, we got to kneel right. And the only way we're going to get on, we're going to have to go down the same road with she now. And I just stopped by and say, I'm a part of the family. Y'all can't kick me out. Y'all can't kick me out. I'm in it, so. I just want to say I love Carrie, I always will, and I always love the family. God bless you.
Amen. Amen.
Y'all ain't moving fast enough. I'm from the same. y'all don't really know, these are kitchen singers. The kitchen singers.
Trouble in my way, trouble in my way, I sometimes.
Amen. Amen. If we fix that, we will fix it. You know, right before I bring the apostle up, you know, I had a lot of time and space the past 3 years to travel from hospitals, doctor visits, nursing homes, a lot of other places we went and not be going, getting groceries or whatever first of the month. It's just a whole lot of things that we knitted in a lot of different things. And some of the pain, a lot of times we prayed a lot, you know, or some of the things she was going through. But I will just not be satisfied unless I say one or two verses of the song that would meet her in the middle of what she was going through. The songwriter say, I had some good days. I had some hills to climb. I had some weary days. And some sleepless nights. But when I look around, I think things over, all of my good days, I weigh my bad days, and I won't complain. Sometimes the clouds hang low, I can hardly see the road, and I ask the question, Lord, why so much pain? But He knows what best for me. Although my weary eyes they cannot see, so I just say, thank you, Lord, and I won't complain. God been so good to me.
Me. All right.
glory to God.
Amen.
The head of all our life.
Amen.
Our creator and our maker.
Lord.
Our all in all. Amen.
Amen.
I often think about the goodness of God.
Yes.
And all that he has done. He has done great things.
Amen.
We have to bless his holy name.
Yes.
I already got my confirmation, so I know I'm in the right place.
Amen.
So we can turn our Bibles to 2 Timothy 4:7-8. We already heard it. We'll hear it again if you got it. Amen. 4:7-8. And then read. I have fought a good fight.
Yes, sir.
I fought a good fight.
Amen.
I finished my course. I've kept the faith. Henceforth, they'll lay up for me a crown of righteousness, which the Lord, the righteous judge, shall give me at that day.
Amen.
Not me only, but to all of them also that love his appearing. Amen. I want to use for a topic today. Love. Can I get everyone to say love?
Love.
You know, I think about Sister Carrie, and I think about her. I think about love because she had a lot of love. She didn't take no wind, did she? But she had a lot of love.
Amen.
Amen. If you were good enough, she would be good to you. But that was Sister Carrie. Today is her day. This is the day that we share. We're doing a homegoing series. One thing about in my walk with the Lord, I found out that, amen, that Sister Carrie not here. She already done transition.
Amen.
But we doing a homegoing service, Lord. We celebrate her life. And as I'm thinking about it, I have another scripture in mind where John 11:24, he said that Martha said unto him, it's talking about during the time that Lazarus, amen, was sick and before he died, when he died, he said, I know that he shall rise again in a resurrection at the last day. In verse 25, Jesus said to her, he said, I am the resurrection and the life.
Amen.
He that believeth in me, though he were dead, yet shall live.
Yeah.
Then he goes on to say, and whosoever liveth and believeth in me shall never die.
Amen.
And then he said, believeth thou this.
All right.
Let me say that one more time. Whosoever liveth and believeth in me shall never die.
Never.
And he said, now believeth thou this.
Yes.
And that one thing about the Lord, he don't lie.
Amen.
So scared. Is that a good place? Man?
Yes, sir.
She's in a place that we all got have to prepare for. And she prepared herself for that time. She prepared herself for such a time as this. Just to care, soul is with the Lord. And not only that, but she had a desire for her church family. And people that she knows. She had a desire, because I talked with a lot of times, many times. She had a desire for them all to get together. And I wondered why she wanted them all to get together. But and I was wondering how could she pull it off. She pulled it off. Look at us now.
Come on, Bob.
That's right.
We together.
All right.
She did.
Uh-huh.
She did it. And here we are, Sister Carrie. We here. And I've been knowing Sister Carrie for over 40 years. And she never wavered in her walk. In other words, it is what it is. And she said what she said is what she meant. But I think about Sister Carrie, but they was how the family used to say that when Sister Carrie was growing up, she loved to dance. Oh, she loved to dance, and she'll dance all day long. And they had to dance with her. And they would dance, but they would dance until her father would tell her, "Oh, girl, you need to cut them reels off. Cut them reels off." But you know that life, it takes us through some changes. And Sister Carrie, she adopted to whatever change come about. And what I mean by that, I said I knew Sister Carrie for a long time. I knew her before I gave my life to the Lord. And I knew her. She was going to church, but she still was working on some things in her life. And she never stopped working on those things. And she worked on those things, cleaned up until the time she went on home to be with the Lord. One thing I could truly say about Sister Carrie, she had it together.
Right.
She made up her mind.
Yes. Right.
She knew that the Lord was on her side. The last time I talked with her, now, she said, "Pastor, you know, the Lord sure will answer prayer." Amen. I said, "Yes, He will, Sister Carrie." She said, "I was in the hospital before the last time she came back to the nursing home." She said, "I was in the hospital and I was in trouble." She said, "But I called on the Lord."
Amen.
"And when I called on to be heard."
Amen.
"And here I am now." And she was having one of the biggest smiles on her face. She said, "God will answer prayer." And I'm trying to let you know, amen, we all need the Lord.
Amen.
Because we all need some prayer answer.
Amen.
In our life.
That's right.
And if we are not saved, we need to be.
Amen.
If you are not giving God any of your time, you need to be.
Amen.
One more thing. Sometimes Sister Carrie would call me and she knew I kind of kept up with numbers and things. And like Pastor Morgan was saying, she would call. But sometimes she would lose the number, misplace the number. She would call me and say, "Pastor, I need Pastor Thomas. I need Pastor Bill. I need some number from the pastor." And she said, and went on and explained to me why she wanted. She said, "I called them. Every pastor that has poured into my life," she said, "I give them a call." She said, "That's what I do because I'm thankful for what they imparted in my life." She used to make massages. I got on one now. And she would make sure that everyone in the church had one. Not only that, she'll make sure that the pen is in there to go with it. And if you didn't know how to pin it on, she'll pin it on water. Huh? She'll make sure, and then she'll tell you what color you need.
Uh-huh.
Sometimes you need a white.
Yeah.
You need a red. But she'll explain to you why you need what you need. Now, she the only person, Sister Carrie, She's the only person that I ever knew that made and ate an oxtail sandwich. Y'all know Sister Gary, eat. And this particular time when we was at the hospital, she said, I didn't have time to eat my oxtail sandwich. So I brought it with me. Now, back to the topic of love. Back to the topic of love. Jesus Christ, love the Lord your God with all your heart and with all your soul and with all your mind. That's what the word says. This is the first and the greatest commandment. Y'all, we got to look.
Amen.
That's the problem with going on in the world today. There's not a lot, there's not enough love.
Amen.
And too much hate.
Amen.
There's a lot of haters in the world. When you hate, you do things that you shouldn't do.
Amen.
Love covers a multitude. Love covers everything.
Amen. Right. Yes, sir.
And if you want to be with the Lord, you got to love.
Yes, sir.
Amen.
Got to love. No matter what, we have to love. And we have to love people that we don't particularly like.
Amen.
That's right.
Amen. People that done you some wrong in your life, you got to love them. He goes on to say, and the second is like, he said, love your neighbor as yourself. And your neighbor is other people.
Amen.
You got to love.
Amen.
Yeah, they did it wrong. So what? You still got to love. Why? Because you got a soul you don't save. And that soul requires us to love. Sister Carrie, she loved her biological family. She loved her church family. She loved people, period. All the suffering is over now. All waiting for something that someone had to do. Waiting to her, it's over now.
Amen.
She had to wait on people to bring her water. You know Sister Carrie, she liked love water. Amen. She had to shake a cup and call someone to bring her some water. It's over now.
Amen.
She can go, she can get her own water.
Amen.
She had to wait for people to bring her food.
Yes.
When she got home. It's over now. She can get all the food. All the waiting is gone with. She had to wait on someone to help her get out of bed. It's over now. She has her mansion now. The word of God say in my Father's house, there are many mansions. And if it were not so, I would not. Oh, he's gone away to prepare a place for you. So that you may be also. She got a mansion now. We don't have ours. But she got hers. I was thought about that. Sister Carrie, she at the time she couldn't walk, but right about now, Sister Carrie. You're walking down those streets that made her go. Sister Carrie said, I'm all right now.
That's right.
No more pain. No more heartache.
No one else having to wait on me. I'm with my mother. I'm with my father. I'm hanging out with Lee Gale. Nickelboy. I'm hanging out with Sophie. I also see Thomas from time to time. Oh, and I was looking at it, and I was thinking about, amen, hallelujah. A lot of people that I knew, amen, that had went on with the Lord. He said, I see them now. I see Happy Jack. I see Jane. I see Tim. And not only that, amen, they remember back in the town when they used to like to dance. They dancing with me. I got my dancing problems. Hallelujah. He said, but look, don't worry about me. Don't bother about me. He said, get your own life in order. Love one another. To look at your neighbor, said, she said, love, amen. Love one another, amen. Because it covers a whole lot of things in your life, amen. Hallelujah. She said, but I'm out of here. I don't feel, I don't know what I've been going through. I don't have to wait, no one to have to wait on me. I got to serve an awesome God. I serve a mighty God. And the Lord that I serve is the same God that you serve. It's the same God, amen, that we're going to have to meet again. And we prepare this life. As we prepare our walk with the Lord. And we prepare, amen, hallelujah, to get ourselves together.
Yes.
God
Jesus
is powerful.
Yes, yes.
His word is powerful.
Yes, Jesus.
And the only way to get to the Father is through the Son.
Yes, sir.
And you can't make it without him.
Amen.
All power in heaven and in earth,
yes,
is in his hand.
Amen.
And if you're not in the hands of the Lord, you're going to miss your walk.
Amen.
I tell you anything that make you feel, but you got to have the Lord on your side.
Amen.
You need to know the truth.
Yeah.
Because the truth is what's going to set you free.
Yeah.
Can you love?
Yeah.
Can you love your neighbor?
All right.
Can you love the Lord?
All right.
Can you not lean to your own understanding? God is on your side. God said, I have made the way for you. I am the truth and the life.
Yes.
With my glory, as I sit down. Make sure that you keep the Lord at the forefront of your life.
Amen.
Glory
Amen.
To God.
Amen.
And away from it, that you can pray.
Thank you.
marriage. Be happy that we've had so many years. I gave you my love, you can only guess how much you gave me in happiness. I thank you for the love that you each have shown, but now it's time that I travel alone. So grieve a while and grieve you must. Then let your grief be comforted by trust. It's only for a while that we must part, so bless the memories within your heart. I will be far away, for life goes on, so if you need me, call and I will come. Though you can't see or touch me, I'll be near. And if you listen with your heart, you'll hear my love around you, so soft and so clear. And then when you too must travel this way alone, I'll greet you with a smile and say welcome home. The family of Mrs. Carrie Belle Jones Johnson is most appreciative for the many kind and loving expressions of sympathy that you each have shown. They ask for your continued prayers and days to come, and may each of you consume the blessings of the Lord. The following floor arrangements have been sent to the family. With deepest sympathy, from Church of God and Prophecy, Pastor and Elder Sharita and Terry Anderson and church family. With deepest sympathy, the Perry and Hardwick families. With deepest sympathy, People of Faith, Christian Church family, Apostle Lawrence Jones, Pastor. With deepest sympathy, from Hunters and Jeff Hill and Rehabilitation. With deepest sympathy, Ark of God Ministries, Pastor David Johnson and Co-Pastor Cynthia Johnson. With deepest sympathy, People of Faith, daycare employees and children. Our thoughts and prayers are with you, Karen Dawson, Calvin Douglas, and Angela Jackson. Thinking of you and wishing you comfort, Deacon Ronnie and Latrell Morris. With deepest sympathy, Deacon Bobby James and family. With deepest sympathy, Evangelistic Tabernacle Church family, Bishop Dr. and Mrs. Arthur West, Pastor. You are in our thoughts and prayers. Love always, Pastor Lamar and Sharon Thomas. Thank you and wishing you a comfort, Mrs. Karen Dawson, Mrs. Angela Jackson, and Mr. Calvin Douglas. In this time of sadness, may you be comforted in the knowledge that others care. Shady Grove, CME Church. As you remember your loved one, may you find comfort in the good times you share and the memories that live on. Carolyn Bill Thomas and the Bill family. The family flower is giving love and memory of a loving care mother, sister, aunt, and friend from the family. And loving memory of Dr. Napoleon Williams, Deacon Arthur L. Parker, CEO and President, along with staff of J.W. Williams Funeral Home, is pleased to present his family an African American Family Heirloom Bible, in the hope that it will serve as a source of added comfort and peace in the days to come. We are also pleased to present to this family a pictorial tribute of your loved one's life. It is our prayer that you will forever remember the many cherished memories you've shared as a family. And finally, we present this memorial blanket. It is our prayer that you wrap yourself in the love and warmth that this blanket holds, and may it be a constant reminder of your beloved. For anyone that is ever loved is never lost. It is our prayer that you're blessed now